Hi, I'm Seb from Shapr3D. In this video, we'll take a look at how Shapr3D's history-based parametric modeling experience can help you create more robust designs. Ever since we launched Shapr3D on top of Parasolid, we've been working to build out more and more of the professional CAD workflow. And this is our biggest release yet. History-based parametric modeling has long been our most requested feature. This is because for engineers and designers, parametric modeling is key to a robust workflow. It lets you create changes even late in the design process, and it enables you to accurately describe your design intent. We asked ourselves, how could we bring history-based parametric modeling into Shapr3D and combine it with everything you already love about the Shapr3D experience? We asked ourselves, what sets Shapr3D apart from other CAD applications? And we feel it is our relentless focus on creating the best possible user experience that maximizes your output. We studied common roadblocks in existing implementations and worked hard to eliminate them and any friction in your workflow. Let's dive right in. As you can see, with the new UI refresh, we haven't changed the overall feeling of the app. We've made room for history-based parametric modeling here on the right side of the screen. First of all, Shapr3D will continue to be great at modeling quickly and creating concepts. If you keep the history sidebar closed, you might not even notice the difference. There are many great benefits to history-based parametric modeling tool. To begin with, it doubles as a full-length undo-redo queue, allowing you to quickly review and make any adjustments to what you've done in the past. Best of all, it is persistent and consistently available across all of your devices. Of course, history-based parametric modeling gives you so much more than just a better undo queue. The most important change is that there's now a connection between your sketches and your 3D bodies, allowing you to change the sketch and immediately modify the bodies that were generated from them. This connection is especially valuable when modifying more complex geometries. Some shapes are easier to define as 2D sketches to begin with, so adjustments are easier there as well. And a huge benefit is that the sketch constraints that you define are applied as you make these changes, ensuring that your design intent and any dependencies on those are automatically honored. But this does not mean that direct modeling is disappearing. If you want to adjust bodies directly, you still can. It will simply create a new step in the history tree. History-based parametric modeling also gives you the option to create copies that live and change together with the original version. This way, you can quickly create and explore variations of the same basic concept, making changes to both the base model and the variations. There are adjustments that are very difficult or even impossible with direct modeling, but these are easy with history-based parametric modeling. For example, the base shape of this mixer cap was created by revolving a profile. Changing it with a simple push-pull operation or extrusions would not be possible. But with history-based parametric modeling, we can simply change the profile and have all the shapes that are built on top of it follow suit. We're still working on adding more features to history-based parametric modeling and iterating on the experience to make sure it's as frictionless as possible. Meanwhile, let us know what you think in the comments of this video. Stay tuned and see you next time.